गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड सीन इन चैप्टर 6 व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रोलाइसिस एंड व्हाट आर इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स एंड नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स. एक्चुअली नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स आर व्हाट दे आर द कंपाउंड which in aqueous or molten state allow electricity to pass through it. Actually what happens when these electrolytes are made aqueous, they dissociate, they decompose to form ions. For examples we will see and ki acid, base and salts, they are electrolytes. How? Not all the acids, some acids are non-electrolytes. Ki acid and alkalis, first of all, what is alkalis? We had studied in the chapter acid base. Metallic oxides or metallic hydroxides are base. There are two types of bases. Some bases are soluble in water. Those bases which are soluble in water are called alkalis. There are in fact only 4 alkalis: sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide and ammonium hydroxide. These two are strong base, strong alkali, they are weak alkalis. Otherwise rest of the bases, whether they are calcium oxide, magnesium oxide, magnesium hydroxide, etc., they are weak alkalis. All the acids and alkalis, they dissociates in water as soon as they are dissolved. Means in the acid base chapter we had studied that all the acids are soluble in water in any proportion. When they are dissolved in water, these acids dissociates. It forms hydrogen ion plus chloride ion, where in water. Now these hydrogen ion cannot exist independently and form hydronium ion. So, like acids, the bases, they also dissociate, they also get dissolved in water. All acids and alkalis are soluble in water, but bases and the salts, base and salts, they dissociate only when they are in fused state or when they are made aqueous. So acid and alkalis ionize when dissolved in water. Just I have told you example ki after adding water, acid and alkalis, they get dissolved and dissociate to form ions. Jabki bases and the salts, they decompose, they dissociate, they form ions only when they are made aqueous or they are fused. There are two types of electrolytes. One is your strong electrolyte and another one is your weak electrolytes. Just like strong acid and weak acid, what we had studied in chapter 3, what is a strong acid? The acid which dissociates completely, which ionizes completely, they are a strong acid, whereas the acid which when dissolved in water, they ionize partially. They are weak acids. Likewise, the electrolytes which ionize completely, they are called, which ionize completely, they are called strong electrolyte, and which ionize partially are called weak electrolytes. Here are some examples of strong electrolytes. This hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, sulfuric acid, these three acids, hydrochloric, nitric and sulfuric, are called inorganic acids. So inorganic acids are good electrolytes, like acetic acids or formic acids, oxalic acid, tartaric acids. These acids are weak electrolytes. Likewise, base, potassium hydroxide and sodium hydroxide, these are strong electrolytes because they dissociate, they ionize completely, whereas these two are weak electrolytes. Likewise, these salts are strong electrolytes, whereas this ammonium carbonate or this is your lead acetate, they are weak electrolytes. Now, what is the difference between strong and weak electrolytes? So electrolytes which allow a large amount of electricity to flow through it, to pass through it, means, I have told you in very simple language what is flow of electron, what is electricity. Electricity, it is a flow of charge. It is a flow of charge. So far we had studied that flow of electron is called electricity, or flow of charge means this positive ion or negative ion. This flow of charges is called electricity. Since the strong electrolytes, they dissociate completely, means large amount of ions will be there, so large amount of electricity will pass. So electrolytes, they allow large amount of electricity to pass through it. Weak electrolyte, they allow less amounts of, small amounts of electricity to pass through it. They are very good conductor of electricity. Weak electrolytes are also conductor of electricity, but they are poor conductor. See, this one we had discussed first. These are almost completely dissociated. Strong electrolytes are completely dissociated, either in fused, molten or aqueous state. They also dissociate. With weak electrolytes also dissociates in fused or aqueous state, but they dissociate or they ionize completely, means some of the molecules will be present in the weak electrolytes. These solutions contains only free mobile ions. They strong electrolytes, they contains only ions, no molecules, because all the molecules of that electrolyte, of that compound, are completely ionized. So no molecules will be present, we'll have only ions. But here, if they are ionizing partially, means some of the molecules will get ionized and some will remain unionized. So weak electrolytes, they have ions as well as molecules. It is a very simple chemistry. When large amount of electricity is passed, if we put a bulb, it will glow very brilliantly. But when less amount of electricity is passed, the bulb will glow faintly. It will glow very dimly. Here are some examples. Just these are same thing. Same thing is here. Okay, what are strong electrolytes? So this hydrogen chloride, sulfuric acid, or even we can say this, if it is made aqueous, will be hydrochloric acid, sulfuric and nitric acid, potassium hydroxide and sodium hydroxide. These salts, they are the examples. And then electrolytes we had studied in our previous classes, the substance which do not substance or compounds which neither in solution nor in molten states, means the substance or the compounds which do not allow electricity to pass through it even in aqueous or molten state are called non-electrolytes. Here are some examples. Before we proceed, once again we would like to see what is ions. Ions are the charges. We are knowing ions are the charges, and there are two types of charge. Ions are what? They are charges. There are two types of charges, positive charge and negative charge. What is positive charge? This positive charge is also called cation, and this one is negative charge is called anion. How positive and negative charges are formed? When a metal, when any metal, if it is sodium, it is a metal, it has 11 atomic number. To attain the inert configuration, means to get 8 electrons in the outermost shell, it will lose one electron, and after losing one electron, it will be positively charged, or this neutral sodium will form this sodium ion. Now this, where will go this lost electron? There will be an any other element. Suppose it is chlorine, its atomic number is 287. Now this chlorine will tend to complete its outermost shell, so this chlorine will gain this lost electron and will form chloride ion. This chloride ion means it will form, it will be negatively charged. So in this chapter electrolysis, we will find the flow of this cation and anion, how they are formed and how do they move. Right, today we will see about the rather we will start this topic, these things, electrolytic cell, what is electrolytic cell, what is electrochemical cell, what is electrodes. We will see it in the next class. And my dear students, for your kind information, some parts of your syllabus has been removed, which we will get today from the ICSE board, and we all the teachers will give you the curtailed syllabus or new syllabus on the next, in the next class. Wish you all the best. Have a good day and try to study well, because you will have very short time for your board exam. Bye bye.